Yeah, dear student, welcome back to the accountancy class. Our chapter going on is accounting equation. So today I am going to solve one comprehensive numerical for you. That is question number 10. The same I have given in you in PPT also the solution, but still I am solving over here. Okay? It's a practical question 10. So first draw the format. Draw a line over here. Write the word transactions, and you are supposed to write just two words only. Here, your mathematical expression or basic assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. So first transaction is started business or business. So cash coming in the business is 60,000. Same, it will represented by capital 60,000. Okay. Paid rent in advance means we have paid rent in advance. So this is for prepaid rent. It is again called an asset. It's 500. So you have paid something, subtract it from cash, 500, and write it here. That is prepaid rent. Same. Okay. Now again, draw the line and write the word new equation. So you are having cash 59,500 plus advance rent or prepaid rent 500. Equals to capital 60,000. After every calculation, you will draw a line and make any accounting equation in order to see whether both the assets are always equivalent to liabilities plus capital, or in mathematical, LH is equal to RHS. Purchase goods for cash and for credit 20,000. Again, you can write over here. Goods purchased. So for cash 30, subtract it from here, and goods is represented through stock. So total stock is 50,000 and 20,000 is credit purchase. So creditor will arise 20,000. Okay. Again, draw a line. Write the word new equation. Cash left with you is 29,500 plus advance rent 500 plus stock 50,000 equal to creditor 20,000 plus capital 60,000. Next, paid salary and outstanding. So how much salary is paid? 500 is paid, subtract it from here. And salary outstanding, again it's a liability, so right here outstanding salary 100. And total is paid and outstanding will be subtracted from capital, because one you have already paid, so capital is reduced and another is the liability which you will pay in future. Okay. Sorry. Write the word new equation. Cash left with you is 29,000 plus advance rent 500 plus stock 50,000 equals to creditor 20,000 plus outstanding salary 100 plus capital 60,000. comes to 59,400. Total is coming 79,500. 79,500 from both the days. Now the next transaction is purchase motorcycle for personal use. So that comes to drawings. Whatever you are doing for the personal use will come under drawing. So subtract 5,000 from here and subtract 5,000 from capital. Okay. Again subtract it. In this way it is done. And the same thing if it is for the business purpose, then you have to subtract it from the cash and write it nearby. If the motorcycle is purchased for business purpose, then it's an asset for the business. Subtract it from the cash and write it here on the asset side. Similarly, if depreciation is provided on the asset, subtract it from that particular asset and from here. Okay, I am giving you a solution over here. It's a drawing. Subtract it. Cash 24,000 plus advance rent, that comes to 500. Plus stock 50,000 equals to creditors 20,000 plus outstanding salary 100 plus capital 54,400. Okay. Now, see if any other asset is purchased, like machinery purchased. Now definitely machinery is for business. I am just giving an example. So for example, machinery is purchased for 4,000. It will come here and it is added here plus machinery 4,000. In this way it is shown. If the asset is purchased for business purpose, then it will come on the asset side. Whatever amount you have withdrawn from the business and you have done anything from the business, anything for personal use, so that will come under drawings only. Whenever if you have even cleared a card, you have thrown the amount in the drainage, sewer, river, sea, whatever it is. There was a severe cold and you burned those money, business has nothing to do. There is only one term, that is called drawings. Okay. Similarly, you have to charge depreciation on asset. So depreciation 10%, subtract 400 from machine and 400 from capital. I am just giving an example how depreciation is treated. In this way, you are supposed to do. Okay. Erase this thing. I am just giving you an example. So, as usual, draw a line, write the word, new equation. Make a total and find it out. That comes to near about 74,500. So your accounting equation is completed. In this way it is done. Okay. Now I will tell you some comprehensive question also. I am erasing this. Now, how to deal with the numericals of consolidated figure? See, question number 18 is there. Capital of the business is 3 lakh. Liabilities are 50,000. And loss equals to 70,000. And you are supposed to find out the total assets. So again, total assets equals to liabilities plus capital minus loss. So liabilities are 50,000, your capital is 3 lakh minus 70,000, so that comes to 2,80,000. In this case of as in the previous class, I will give you one more thing. You can write over here, so if profit and expenses are given, plus revenue minus expense, you can calculate profit. See one question number 20. A commenced his cloth business on 1st April 18 with a capital of 30,000 and 31st March 19 his assets were 50,000 and liabilities are 10. Find out his closing capital and profit earned during the year. See here. Capital on 1st April equals to 30,000. Now you have to, in order to find out the profit, you are supposed to find out closing capital. The formula is closing assets minus liabilities. So its closing assets are 50,000 and liabilities are 10,000. So closing capital is 40,000. Now you can find out profit equal to closing capital minus opening capital. So 40,000 minus 30,000. So profit and during the year is 10,000. You can also see in the similar way, you have started business with a capital of 30,000 and at the end you are having closing capital is 40, so definitely difference would be profit only. One more numerical I am solving. Here also you are supposed to, it's question number 22, you have to find out total assets. So capital is 40,000, revenue 50,000 and expenses is 40,000. So again your formula is total assets equals to liabilities plus capital plus revenue minus expenses. So liabilities are not given, your capital is 40 plus revenue 50 minus 40. Also, liabilities are given, creditors are 25,000. So 25 plus 40, 60, 5 plus 50, 150 minus 40, that comes to 75.
solve the comprehensive numerical.
Solve it and let me know your doubts. Just WhatsApp me your problem. Click a photo of your problem and WhatsApp me.
I can try to give you a real-time solution. Thank you. Happy learning.